Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.2, Problem 5. This is Section 3.2, Problem 5, and it says minimize z equals 2x plus y subject to 4x plus y is greater than or equal to 12, 2x plus y is greater than or equal to 8, x is greater than or equal to 0, and y is greater than or equal to 0. So to do a problem like this, there are four steps. Step one is graph your feasible region. Step two is label your corner points. Step three is fill out the chart. And step four is state your solution. So let's go through those steps. Step one is graph the feasible region. So the things that get graphed are the parts of the problem that have inequality symbols. We do not graph the one thing that has an equal sign that's an equation. That comes in later. So I'll start with 4x plus y is greater than or equal to 12. So to graph that, I'm going to make a little xy chart next to it and find two points that would make this true if I pretend it's an equation, if I pretend it's equals 12, not greater than or equals 12. So first, I'm going to let x equals 0. And if I pretend it's an equals, I just have y equals 12. Easy enough. And to get a second point, if I now pretend y is 0 and I have an equals, I have 4x equals 12. So to make it 12 equals 12, x must be 3. So I have my two points. And I can put them on my graph. So 0, 12 means go over 0, up 12. And then 3, 0 means go over 3, up 0. So I have the two points. I'll connect them with a nice straight line. There's the first linear inequality. Now I have to shade above the line or below it. And to determine which side I shade, choose a test point that's not on the line. Use 0, 0 if you can. So 0, 0 is not on the line. If I put in 0 for x, 0 for y, I get the statement 0 is larger than 12, which is not true. So if my test point was underneath, it gave me a result that's not true. The underneath side is the blank side. Therefore, the opposite side, the above side, would be the shaded side. That. Now, the next inequality with the 8 at the end, I'm going to do that graph in a different color for a little more clarity. I'm going to do that one in red. So now, 2x plus y is greater than or equal to 8. So I'm going to set up a little xy chart next to that one, too. And I'm going to start with letting x equal 0. And I pretend it's 2x plus y equals 8. So if I let x equal 0, the 2x pretty much goes away, and I have y equals 8. And then next, I'll let y equal 0. I pretend it's equal. So I pretend I have 2x equals 8, so x would be 4. So I have 2 points, 0, 8, and 4, 0. So I'll put those on the graph. 0, 8 is over 0 and up 8. And 4, 0 is over 4 and up 0. Now, let me take my ruler, and I will connect those. Now, at this point, I have to determine whether I shade below the red line or above it. And to do that, I'm going to pick a test point that's not on the line, use 0, 0 if I can. 0, 0 is not on the line. So I'll use 0, 0 as my test point, 0 for x, 0 for y. I get the result 0 is greater than 8, not true. 0 is not greater than 8. So my test point was on the underneath side. Result was false. Therefore, the underneath side is blank because I got a false result, which means the opposite side is shaded, the above side. Like that. And now, the next one, x is greater than or equal to 0 is the next constraint, or linear inequality. That just means all the points in my feasible region have to have only positive x values, so only points that are to the right of the y-axis. So for what I have shaded here, It's going to come in from here. I'm not even going to go below the lines that I drew because that's not part of my feasible region. And the last constraint is the linear inequality, y is greater than or equal to 0. It means that I can only have points in my feasible region with positive y values. So I have to stay above the x-axis. And again, I don't even go to the left of the lines that I already have drawn because I just can't use those. So now the area that satisfies everything is pretty large area. This is an unbounded feasible region because it goes forever. So step one, graph the feasible region, is complete. So we move on to step two, label the corner points. So one corner point of my feasible region is 0, 12. Zero, 8 is not a corner point. We use it to make the graph, but it's not a corner point of my feasible region. It doesn't touch the feasible region. This point where the red and the blue line intersects is a corner point. That's a little tougher to find. I'll come back to that one in a second. 3, 0 is not a corner point. Again, it doesn't touch the feasible region. 4, 0, however, is a corner point. So back to this one, where the red line and the blue line intersect. So what I have to do is solve the two equations simultaneously that are intersecting. So I'm going to come off to one side. I'm going to write 4x plus y equals 12. Again, in the problem, it says greater than or equal to 12. Just think of it as an equals, just in terms of finding the coordinates of the point of intersection. And the other one, 2x plus y equals 8. Again, don't bother with the inequality to find the coordinates of the point of intersection. So what I would like to do is make one of the variables have the same number in front but with opposite signs. So I could go with 4x and negative 4x if I like, or positive y, negative y. I should get the same answer either way. The y's are going to be a little bit easier to deal with, so I'll go with y. So the top equation can stay as is, which would be 4x plus y equals 12. Nothing will change. The bottom equation, however, I'm going to do everything times minus 1. And the reason I do that is because I want to have minus y. But I can't just make the y negative. I have to do minus 1 times every part of it. So minus 1 times 2x will be negative 2x. Minus 1 times y is negative y. And minus 1 times 8 is negative 8. Now I can add those two equations together. So I combine the x's. 4x and negative 2x is positive 2x. Negative y cancels, which is what I want. And then positive 12 and negative 8 is positive 4. So if 2x equals 4, I can divide out the 2 and have x equals 2. So the point of intersection here, the x-coordinate is 2, but I have to find the y-coordinate also. It looks like it should be 4 by my graph, but you can't always rely on a graph, especially if you've drawn it freehand. I drew mine pretty accurately, but take the answer for the variable you found, in this case being x is 2. Go back to either of the original equations and put in your answer, in this case of x is 2, and solve the other variable. The bottom equation seems a little bit easier. If x is 2, 2x becomes 2 times 2. I have 4 plus y equals 8. Well, 4 plus something is 8, the y must be 4. So now, step two of my four-step process is label the corner points. I have them labeled. Step three is fill in that chart. So let's set up the chart. I can fit it right here, I think. So one column, the first column is for the corner points. The middle column I leave a little bit wider. That's for the object function. So for this particular problem, my object function is z equals 2x plus y. And the last column is for output. So I only have three corner points. So I only need three rows. One of the corner points is 0, 12. Another corner point is 2, 4. And the last corner point is 4, 0. So try the x and y values of each corner point in the object function. The first one being 0, 12 would give me a result of z equals 2 times x becomes 2 times 0 plus y is plus 12. And when you do the math, 2 times 0 is 0. You add 0 plus 12 and you get an output of 12 at that corner point. The next corner point is 2, 4, so x is 2 and y is 4. So when I put that in the object function, the result would be 2 times x becomes 2 times 2, plus y becomes plus 4. So 2 times 2 is 4, plus another 4 after that. 4 plus 4 gives me an output of 8. And finally, 4, 0 is my last corner point. So now when I put the 4, 0 in my object function, 2 times x becomes 2 times 4, plus y is plus 0. 2 times 4 is 8, and then 8 plus 0 is 8 again. So now we want to minimize this. The smallest output we can get is 8, because our choices are 12, 8, or 8 again. So the last step of the four steps is state your solution. The solution is going to be minimum of 8 at the point. Now usually I write at the point, but in this case I have to write at the points because there's more than one. That 8 can come from 2 comma 4. Or also 4 comma 0. So a minimum of 8 at the points 2 comma 4 or 4 comma 0. 2 comma 4 or 4 comma 0. Now in reality, not only those two corner points will produce that minimum output of 8, but every one of the points on the line that connects 0, 4, 4, 0 and 2, 4 would also give you that minimum of 8.